Good afternoon, dear audience. My name is Dr. Ahmed Adel Amragi. I'm a lecturer of cardiovascular medicine in Cairo University. I was presenting today a case of calcified left main bifurcation disease in a 73-year-old male who was hypertensive and smoker. This patient had chronic severe angina, Kennedy class 2, that progressed to become 3 and even 4 in the late days before presentation. He did a coronary angiography 3 months earlier that showed multivessel disease for bypass surgery, and the patient refused to do surgery. When I saw the patient, he was in clinic class 4, and I did another coronary angiography for him, and I saw a distal left main calcified tight lesion involving the ostium of the LAD that caused a slow flow in the LAD, as well as a severe stenosis of the ostium of the LCX. So I did a two-stent technique from the beginning, and I did a mini crush technique because the patient was unstable and was 73-year-old man who was restless on the table of the cardiac cath. So I started by balloon dilating both vessels. Unfortunately, I didn't have a rotablator on site, so I did a non-compliant balloon dilation of the LAD in order to avoid any residual calcification that may be protruding the lumen and prohibiting stent deployment. Then I did a stent deployment of the ostium of the LCX, protruding 1 to 2 struts into the left main, and it was covered by another stent in the LAD, left main LAD, after deployment of the stent in the LCX, and making sure that it was fully deployed with no dissections, I did inflation of the left main LAD stent to crush the stent in the LCX. Then I did recrossing of the wires into the LCX again, and I did final kissing. Unfortunately, I didn't have a short non-compliant balloon to do a POT, so I ended by final kissing. And it was a good result, and the patient was stable, and I'm following him now for almost a year, and he's doing fine. Thank you.